A very good morning, students. Let us discuss a very important concept regarding nozzle efficiency. When a steam flows through a nozzle, the final velocity of steam for a given pressure drop is reduced due to the following reasons. Okay. The friction between the nozzle surface and steam, the internal friction of steam itself, and the shock losses. Okay, these are the reasons due to which pressure drop is reduced in the steam nozzle. Okay, that pressure loss causes less in nozzle efficiency, or that pressure drop causes less nozzle efficiency. Most of these frictional losses occur between the throat and exit in convergent divergent nozzle. These frictional losses entail the following effects. Okay, these frictional losses entail the following effects. Let us see those. The expansion is no more isentropic and enthalpy drop is reduced. Okay, the expansion is no more isentropic and enthalpy drop is reduced. We know that enthalpy drop is equal to increase in the kinetic energy, so enthalpy drop should not be reduced. Then the final dryness fraction of steam is increased as the kinetic energy gets converted into heat due to friction and is absorbed by the steam. Okay, then third one, the specific volume of steam is increased as the steam becomes more dry due to this frictional heating. So these are the effects of frictional losses. Then in next slide we will see Mollier diagram, the effect of friction on steam flow through a nozzle. Okay, flow through a nozzle. We can see a diagram here, effect of friction on steam flow through a nozzle. How the friction has its own effect on steam flow through a nozzle. The point one represents the initial condition of steam. In the diagram you can observe initial condition of a steam which enters the nozzle in a dry saturated state. If the friction is neglected, the expansion of steam from entry to throat is represented by vertical line. Okay, I will show here the point one. This point one represents the initial condition of steam which enters the steam nozzle in a dry saturated state. If the friction is neglected, the expansion of steam from entry to throat is represented by vertical line 1 to 2 if the friction is neglected, and that from the throat to exit is 2 to 3 if the friction is neglected. Now if the friction were taken into account, the heat drop would have been somewhat less than the 1 to 3. If you won't consider the frictional loss, then heat drop will be 1 to 3. But if you consider, let the heat drop be 1 to 3 dash. From 3 dash, draw a horizontal line which cuts the same pressure line on which this 3 lies. Okay. At the point 2 dash, you will get. Okay, if you draw horizontal line from the point 3 dash, and you will get a line and where this pressure line cuts, which represents the final condition of steam, which is at 2 dash. It may be noted that from the Mollier diagram you can note that the dryness fraction of steam is more at point 2 dash than the point 3. If you consider frictional losses, then the final condition will be 2 dash. Then the point 3 at 2 dash dryness fraction is more than at point 3. Hence the effect of friction is to improve the quality of steam, because it reheats the steam, because this frictional losses or friction in the friction between the nozzle and the steam will increase the heat content of the steam. So that is why it improves the quality of steam. The value of coefficient k in the equation for the velocity of expanding steam is given by k, actual heat drop by isentropic heat drop. Actual heat drop in the nozzle is 1 to 3 dash from here to here, 1, 2, 3 dash. So actual heat drop means when considering the frictional losses. If you want to consider friction losses, isentropic heat drop, that is standard heat drop 1, 2, 3. So at 1 enthalpy value is h1, at 3 dash enthalpy value is h3. So h1 minus h3 dash by h1 minus h3. The actual expansion is represented by the curve 1 to 2 dash. Actual expansion is represented by the line 1 to 2 dash. Isentropic expansion is 1 to 3 dash. Okay. Since the frictional occurs mainly between the throat and exit. On the other hand, if the steam at entry to nozzle were superheated corresponding to the point 4, you can observe diagram here. The expansion can be represented by the vertical line 4 to 6 if friction were neglected, and by 4, 5 to 5 dash if the friction were taken into account. In this case, K equal to 4 to 6 dash divided by 4 to 6, which is equal to H4 minus H6 dash divided by H4 minus H6. The point 5 dash represents the final condition of steam. It may be noted that the friction tends to superheat steam. I told you that the friction between the steam and the nozzle and the friction inside the steam itself will increase the heat content of the steam. So that increase in heat content of the steam improves the quality of steam by increasing the temperature. Therefore, it can be concluded that friction tends to decrease the velocity of steam and increase the final dryness fraction or superheat the steam. Very important term we need to remember here. Therefore, it can be concluded that friction tends to decrease the velocity of steam and increase the final dryness fraction or superheat the steam. Then, now we can define the nozzle efficiency is therefore defined as the ratio of the actual enthalpy drop to the isentropic enthalpy drop between the same pressures. Then mathematically, nozzle efficiency is equal to H1 minus H3 dash divided by H1 minus H3, or H4 minus H6 dash by H4 minus H6, as the case may be. If the actual velocity at exit from the nozzle is C2 dash and the velocity at exit when the flow is isentropic is C3, then using the steady flow energy equation, in each case we have H1 plus C1 square by 2, which is equal to H3 plus C3 square by 2, or H1 minus H3 equal to C3 square minus C1 square by 2, and H1 plus C1 square by 2, which is equal to H2 dash plus C2 dash square by 2, or H1 minus H2 dash, which is equal to C2 dash square minus C1 dash square by 2. Okay. Therefore, nozzle efficiency is C2 dash square minus C1 square divided by C3 square minus C1 square. Call it as 18.13 equation. When the inlet velocity C1 is neglected or negligibly small, then because usually initial velocity at inlet is very less, that's why we will neglect. The nozzle efficiency becomes C2 dash square divided by C3 square. Call it as equation 18.4. Sometimes a velocity coefficient is defined as the ratio of actual exit velocity to the exit velocity when the flow is isentropic between the same pressure. Then velocity coefficient is equal to C2 dash by C3. It can be seen from equation 18.4 and 18.5 that the velocity coefficient is the square root of the nozzle efficiency. You can observe here from the 18.4 and 18.5. It can be observed that the velocity coefficient is the square root of the nozzle efficiency when the inlet velocity is assumed to be negligible.